Reports say a key Iranian nuclear site was rocked by a massive underground explosion. Question, was this a deliberate attempt to sabotage their nuclear development? The explosion reportedly took place at the Fordo nuclear facility. It's about 80 miles south of Tehran early last week. Iran's state news agency denies it, but why would anyone believe them? Let's talk to syndicated radio talk show host John Batchelor. Why would anyone believe the Iranian news agency, John? Was there an explosion? That's question number one.
High probability, an explosion on Monday the 25th. This is confirmed with multiple sources now reporting over the weekend, sources associated with German intelligence, with British intelligence, with Israeli intelligence. High probability, Larry. And the sun coming up tomorrow doesn't have as high a probability.
All right, so we believe it happened. Now, who, where, when, and why? Who did this, John? Is this an inside job or what?
I'm told right now that it was an explosion deep inside the facility, that there are 190 to 200 people trapped or dead. As of yesterday, there was indication there are survivors. However, the rescue efforts haven't started yet because of fear of radiation. Who did this? Who fears radiation, radioactivity, an enrichment program, nuclear weapons from Iran? There are two obvious choices. One is Israel, one is the United States.
You believe that the U.S. and or Israel may have been responsible for this?
I think every piece of logic I have points to the fact that Israel is the chief suspect right now, chiefly because last Tuesday, the day after the event, I'm told important national security meetings in Tehran. One involved the supreme leader, the head of the IRGC, and the head of Quds Force. And at that point, I'm told the supreme leader approved of preparations for retaliation against Israel, probably out of Lebanon. The southern Bekaa right now, that's the valley that abuts Israel, is being evacuated in preparation for an action. So Tehran believes it was Israel. I'll stay with that, Larry.
All right. A year ago, or less than a year ago, we had a power breakdown at this very same nuclear plant, Fordo nuclear plant, if I'm pronouncing it right. Do you think that was Israel?
That was mid-August 2012. Yes, I do. That was on the surface. A month later, the Iranians themselves admitted to that attempt to sabotage Fordo. Why Fordo? Fordo is the heart of the Iranian suspect nuclear weapons program. Fordo is the bargaining chip that Iran brings to the table when it bargains directly with the Obama administration. Fordo is their guarantee of having a nuclear weapon while being prepared to sign onto a grand bargain with the United States. The fact that Fordo is now damaged, and perhaps seriously damaged, the indications right now we're going to have a lot more details. There are foreign nationals involved. There are a lot of people down there. There are a lot of families who are worried right now. That will change significantly the calculus of the Obama administration with regard to Iran in the years ahead.
How does that change the calculus? You think because it will weaken the Iranian program? I mean, was this Israeli operation, as you put it, that effective?
Very effective right now. The information, Larry, again, we're going with what we have. Very effective, chiefly because Iran cannot now complain that Israel attacked its secret nuclear weapons program, one that it isn't supposed to have. Also, we know that the Obama administration is in active conversation with the supreme leader right now for a grand bargain. Suddenly, Israel plays a card. Significant detail here. The attack took place the day before the Israeli election, the day before Benjamin Netanyahu was returned to form a government. He is now forming a government. This is huge news in Israel. All of the television stations will be going with it tomorrow. The newspapers are going with it now.
You say the United States government is negotiating a grand bargain with Iran? That is nuts. Have they learned nothing in the Team Obama?
September 1938 is my watchword for what's going on right now. We're looking at making a deal with the supreme leader, who is a predator and leads a predator state with the nuclear weapons. Ask Moscow right now where its missing technicians are at Fordo. Ask Ukraine right now where its missing technicians are. I don't have those answers. We'll get them in the coming days if there's a rescue effort. There's fear of radiation, Larry. This is a huge story if it's a nuclear accident.
Well, I get that, and that is going to be important to a lot of innocent civilians. I get that, but unfortunately, war is war. I mean, John, I think blowing up Fordo and any other of these nuclear plants would be a lot more effective than negotiating with Iran, which strikes me as unbelievably naive and counterproductive.
January 21st. 2013. That's the date of the explosion, we're told so far. That could be a significant event in world history, Larry, if this put an end to Iran's nuclear weapons program.
All right, that's terrific stuff. I got just a second, John, just a second. Israel hitting Syria, yes or no? Israel hitting Syria over weapons of the chemical weapons.
If they use WMD, yes.
It's on the table. John Baxter, great stuff. As always, tremendous information.